This is Unrivaled Skyrim, and today I'm going to be doing this Total War Rome 2 battle replay. I am going to be playing as the RDI, and my opponent he played as Chimera. His name is Fusilier649. Let's go ahead and jump into this battle. This battle is from over a week ago. I played this guy. He's a really nice guy. I was the host. I think the rules were, my standard rules whenever I host is like, no artillery. Even though I don't really care about artillery so much if someone uses them. And like the max, I think in this battle, I did max 5 of the same unit. So you couldn't bring more than 5 of the same unit. I usually do 6, but I think 5 is good enough. But my army in a nutshell, I think I had 2 noble hoplites. The Illyrian noble hoplites have both of them in the center. My general is in one of them. And I also have, I think, 4, actually maybe 5 Illyrian hoplites. I have 4 mercenary axe warriors. Should have brought more of those. I think they're a really good unit for the cost for the RDI. I have 2 slave slingers, and I also had brought 2 mercenary peltas units. For my cav, I think I have 2 or 3 Illyrian cav. Yeah, 2 Illyrian cav. Illyrian cav, honestly, the only good thing I would... I mean, they're classified as medium melee cav. I don't know if they were classified as light cav back at, when they first came out. But, let's see here. But now they're medium melee cav. Their use is pretty much just chase down skirmishers, in my opinion. They'll get torn to pieces in a prolonged melee engagement with other cav. And I also have 2 mercenary Tarantine cav. Let's go over his army, at least what's visible right now. He's got a mixture of young axes and the Chimerian noble infantry, and he also has Scythian hoplites. And he brought a healthy force of, I think he brought 3 heavy archers, and he also brought pig peltas, which I is a good unit in this case, and especially on this map where it's very forested. So any long range missile unit kind of has a disadvantage, although you could say the same about any peltas unit. But what's going on, I'm gonna move my main force into this patch of forest right here, and in the meantime I'm scouting this area over here because I expected there to be some horse archers or some cav in this and over in this region. And sure enough, I do find some units. He's got a unit of step lancers, and they are with these armored horse archers. I need to get rid of these horse archers for late game, because if I let them survive and have a lot of ammunition towards late game, that will really mess with my chances of winning. So, and he also has another step lancer moving out over here. So here I'm gonna try to get some javelins into his cav over here, and his step lancers are gonna charge, and actually do manage to catch some of my cav. But I'm gonna get my cav out of there. I think I did have them in skirmish mode, but for some reason, you gotta be careful. You can't just leave your missile cav on skirmish mode and just expect them to run away immediately. Sometimes they're really slow, so I'm gonna lose 25. Almost 30, more than 30 cav just in that engagement alone. He's gonna take some losses because I got some javelins in him, so he's gonna pursue. And at the same time, I made a huge mistake. I was gonna bring up this unit of mercenary Tarantine cav to take some javelins into his heavy archers, but he's just gonna focus fire and just totally destroy this cav unit. It's just a huge waste. That's a blunder on my part. I just was not thinking. That was a huge mistake on my part, and it's really gonna hurt me in the end. So if you have a unit like this, don't throw it away. learn from my mistakes. But yeah, I'm gonna bring my slave slingers. They're not gonna do whole lot of damage against his archers and his pig peltes, but I'm just gonna be exchange missiles with them anyways, just to for the most part, I'm just gonna try to drain their missiles. I should have them in the forest so they had that block chance, so that's what I'm doing right now. I'm gonna retreat them back in the forest so they receive some cover from missiles. And over here, he is still pursuing this unit of mercenary Tarantine Cav. I had brought in three of those. Yes, I had brought in three of those mercenary Tarantine Cav. I think I only said two at the beginning. But here, this is when I say enough's enough. I'm going to go ahead and charge this mercenary Illyrian Cav. I'm going to turn it around and I'm going to help with some Axe Warriors. So I'm going to get some javelins off and they're going to charge into my Illyrians. And they actually get a few kills off of my Illyrian Cav, but I'm going to be quick to counter charge and just swarm that unit. And he's following up with a horse archer. With this unit over here, I put it into hiding, thinking maybe he would just forget about it. But let's see what happens. Over here, I'm going to pretty much destroy that that step lancer, and I'm going to try my best to just pounce at this horse archer. I want to get it off the field as quickly as possible. They're going to take off running towards the forest. Good idea. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to try to cut off his escape, so going to the right, and this Illyrian Cav is actually going to catch some of his horse archers. So he's lost a unit of Cav, I've lost a unit of Cav so far. And here, this is when they catch up to these horse archers. They are actually taking some losses fleeing from my Illyrian Cav. Medium missile cav, so they're classified as the same weight, so they should have the same speed in my opinion. I don't know if that's necessarily true, but they're both classified as medium, so they should have the same speed. But here I totally catch this unit and in melee combat even. It's Illyrian Cav's just, I don't know, is when it is at half strength. But even with javelins coming in, I think I should have been able to destroy this unit. But it's getting close to his reinforcements. He was bringing up a unit of Militia Hoplite to reinforce. And over here, I had to run this unit out of there, out of the forest. He saw it with his other horse archery unit, and I wanted to save it and retreat from that area. So Fusilier, he's doing a good job, in my opinion. He did lose a step lancer, but he has more cav, and plus, in my opinion, his he's got a really good infantry corps, and he's got a heck of a lot better skirmishing corps than me. I just have to use my numbers correctly now. I mean, I think I do outnumber him in infantry, but I think overall the quality is on his side. These Cimmerian noble infantry, in this case, they also have and plus they're cool looking. They have cloaks. Just a really cool looking unit. I mean, they got their shields down right now, but going to cinematic. Cool how they have cloaks, but you know, I like the patterns on their shields too. But they also have expert charge defense. So here he's pretty much taking out my slave slingers. I'm not really too worried about it. They're really cheap units. I just really want to have him just use all of his missiles and just be a nuisance, really. I think I've not even gotten many kills with these slingers. Yeah, this unit's only got 11 kills, and the other one it only got 9. That's just terrible. But I didn't bring too many slave slingers, just knowing that Cimmeria, you know, they can out skirmish me any day of the week, so I'm not going to focus on that area. Potentially where I would have the edge is the top tier to mid tier hoplite units. So Illyrian hoplites are actually better statistics. I'm not going to go over them, but just to scroll over them so you can pause the video and compare and contrast. Galarians have more health, and more armor. But Scythians, they have better melee defense, and they have a better, actually, they have a better bonus versus large too, and slightly less melee and weapon damage. So I don't know. There's trade-offs. I think in my mind that Illyrian hoplites would be better than a Scythian hoplite. But here I'm actually going to be aggressive. I'm going to move towards this flank over here. I'm going to advance with some mercenary axe warriors. This mercenary axe warrior in a situation where I could get it in the flank of an unbraced noble infantry, where it wouldn't be able to use its expert charge defense. I would be able to inflict here. I'll be able to inflict a lot of damage, but that's a really cool, that'd be a cool screenshot. See them cheering. Come on, do it again. Of course, they're not going to do it when I'm... Alright, that's cool. Oh, do it again. There we go. Alright. Probably used that as a thumbnail, but yeah, I'm slowly advancing. I'm just keeping my, some units of cav hidden over here. I'll keep them in reserve, and plus to rest them, they're winded. Well, that unit's fresh. But Illyrian cav, I don't know, it's just, it's offensive capabilities against heavy infantry, and especially melee cav, it's just almost useless. And he does have a unit of Steplancers over here, but he'll be charging in the forest, so his charge, if he were to charge, it wouldn't be as effective, and plus it's at around half strength. So here I'm actually going to be aggressive. I'm going to charge into his step lancers. Let's see here. Let's watch this clash. Let's see here. I think they get a few kills off the. Yeah, they get a few kills off the charge. But he's going to reinforce with young axes. They're like a cheaper version of my axeman. He's actually getting here. I'm gonna counter charge that, you know, my own axe warrior. They're gonna take a bunch of losses, but here he's gonna actually charge with his primary noble infantry. Good idea on his part, and he's bringing over a pig peltis, so he did a good job of reinforcing that that his left flank. And now he's throwing javelins into my Illyrian cavalry. I'm wanting to try to charge through. See, I have a movement order in place. But I do a really, I don't know, an unorthodox thing. I'm actually going to engage and charge. These Scythians, they don't have expert charge defense, but they do have 71 melee defense now that they're in shield wall. And I bunch up. This was a huge mistake. I bunch up two Illyrian hoplites, and now he's getting shots with his archers on their exposed flanks. Oh man, I didn't know it was that bad until watching this. Like this is like the third time I've watched this replay. But here I'm trying to get at his picked peltas, but his picked peltas are actually relatively good in a melee fight. This Illyrian cav is losing decisively. So, I don't know. Illyrian cav, I think that would be their only good use is maybe charge down, just light horse archers or skirmisher cav or whatever, or chasing down light missile infantry. I think Marian heavy archers, I think they come with a short spear, so they can actually be useful against fending off light to medium cav. But here he's going to lose a young axe, and see, I do have charges. I did get some good charges on these Scythian hoplites. For some reason, I only put one of my Illyrian hoplites in the hoplite. Well, I should have got all of them, and but he's getting some javelins into my my hoplites, so that's going to force me to bring out the rest of my forces. I do have more axe warriors. Combat even. So the combat is even right now, but he does have more in reserve, and these skirmishers are just going to keep on firing upon me. I just can't I don't know, my cav just can't get to them. I did try to bring a few units over here to take out his archers, but I forgot to put an attack order, and these horse archers are just going to just wreak havoc on my Tarantine cav. I probably should have charged them, but they're depleted to begin with, and he's going to go ahead and countercharge and take out my Tarantine cav. So I'm out of cavalry. So those horse archers, and I'm sure they still have a lot of ammunition, they're going to be a pain. And here, he's going to use his pig pelters very well to take out this unit of Illyrian Hoplites. I should have had that Illyrian Hoplite charging someplace else to help out in this fight. I'm losing badly on the fight on this right flank. And this is when I'm going to bring in my own Mercenary Peltas, but he's going to do a smart thing. He is actually going to, he's eventually going to charge and try to disrupt my Mercenary Peltas. For some reason, I'm targeting his Pig Peltas right now. It's not the thing I should be doing. I should be targeting his Noble Infantry. His Noble Infantry is down to 50, but I need to get rid of that unit to have any chance of winning that flank. But see, he's going to disrupt my Peltas. I didn't want to get into a fight. I should have brought this Tarantine cav to charge that. That's what I'm doing right now. See, his Peltas, he's using his Pig Peltas really well to disrupt my own Peltas, because they need to be firing at this Noble Infantry like right now. Because I am not making any unit winning decisively. I'm not making any progress in the middle. I think eventually I would win, but I'm losing on the flanks. And plus he has these armored horse archers firing on my flanks. And plus he still has his general, which is still fresh. So he's going to now activate his rally ability, try to bolster up morale. And here I'm losing terribly on the left, on his left, my right. This unit of Illyrian Hoplites was getting picked apart by javelin fire, and it just goes to show that, I don't know, if I had just had one unit just charge in instead of just be blobbed up, it would have helped me in the end. See, that unit only got 53 kills, and this unit only got 50 kills, so most of those hoplites got killed by missile fire. See, my thinking was, if I can charge, and I was expecting him to go in a hoplite wall, but I was going to be able to charge and get my men around his flanks, as you see right now, as they're doing, then this infantry line would just crumble, and then I would be able to take out the, or at least hold on this flank, at least this flank, not so much the left, but just defeat them in the center and on this flank. But it didn't work out. I think I made some really bad mistakes. If I had that one Tarantine cav from the beginning, it really would have done myself better. And I think, honestly, Illyrian cav in this situation, I don't know if they would have been worth it in the long run. But we'll see at the end of the battle. I mean, just still, the balance bar is still in the middle. But, oh no, it's just not looking good for me. In the center, he's holding, he still has these armored horse archers. I think he has at least two units of those. And one unit of Militia Hoplites come back from routing. And he's just getting some point blank heavy shot. I would imagine he's using heavy shot into my general. And they're just, I don't know, picking apart my Noble Hoplite, my general, and I'm starting to lose in the center. Only 67 kills, so, man, there's still 4 minutes into this battle. I'm going to go ahead and speed it up, but yeah, Fusilier, I think he did a good job. I think overall, I think I shouldn't have had him, or I should have had him charge me up on the hill, because I had the high ground, I had the terrain advantage. I thought I could just easily charge downhill, use that charge bonus, and just get around his flank and use my mercenary axeman and to get around while my hoplites held his in place. But it didn't really work out. But let's go ahead and speed this up. It takes him a while to kill my remaining forces in the middle. And here he's gonna finally get to my mercenary peltas. I think in my opinion I should have brought, just not even messed with bringing the slave slingers, because overall I don't think they used up that much ammunition of the of his archers. Even his archers I think are fighting with their own spears, so that they must be out of ammunition. So he's like, you know what, might as well have them charge in. So you know what, let's go ahead and go and get some cinemags, why not? Oh, that's pretty cool. That'd make a pretty cool thumbnail. I'm always thinking about thumbnails. Let's take a look at the kills right now. This unit's got 94, while this Valyrian Noble Hoplite has 340. God damn. Excuse me, but that's crazy. And this other one has 160. So I must have brought 3 or 4 Noble Hoplites. I thought I only brought 2. This one has gotten 2 experience chevrons. So this is the last, my last 2 units are actually getting a lot of kills. Let's see. This one is winded, and this one is winded, and I'm sure his other units are exhausted, and that's why. Okay, this one unit's fresh, but they're totally surrounded right now. Let's go ahead and let's not do that for you. Your kid's kind of disorienting when you do that, but you know what? The one thing I hate, I can't remember which patch they did it. I think it was like either 14 or 15. Instead of having the units crop near the edge of the screen, now they just have them fade away just like that. I really hate that. I know there's a way to change that, but I'm just so lazy. I don't know how to do it for one thing. I have to look it up, but I'm just so lazy. Is this one unit routing? No, he's just charging it in. No, there's no way. But about a minute left, just some discussion what happened. I don't know, I think I got too bold. I thought I wouldn't say that I won the initial skirmishing with his calf, but it wasn't even trade-off, and I thought, well, you know what? Well, with what I have left, I can be able to charge down the hill and easily defeat him in the center. Because my axes will be able to get around, and he doesn't really have really that much offensive cav to really stop that from happening. Oh, now he's gonna get a charge with his horse archers, and that's pretty much gonna kill my guys. I mean, they'll have around 100 men, but they're just gonna shatter from the losses. But let's go ahead and take a look at the statistics. See, this one unit did get 78 kills. That was probably the one that got into his horse archers. This one horse archer, he got 246 kills. More than paid for itself. These Tarentine calves. This is the one that I just pretty much threw away. I think it would have helped me a lot if I had. Sorry, that's just my phone. If I had just not thrown it away. Peltas did wonders for me. These hoplites, I think they would have done better, but I did blob up 2 of them, so pretty much it was 3 versus his, he brought 5 of those Scythian hoplites, and he brought 3 of those noble infantry. And my noble hoplites, except my general was the one getting shot from behind. It did get a rear charge on some of his units, but I don't know, with all that missile fire, he must have got torn to pieces, but and my ex-warriors did a well job, but and we pretty much had the same amount of men deployed. It's just that my weak cav and my weak skirmishers really couldn't couldn't be any benefit to me in this situation. I think I was too bold to charge down the hill. I had a better terrain. I should have just had him charge me up in the forest, honestly. I didn't want to play defensive in this battle. I kind of wanted to come after him because Chimera is a skirmish heavy faction, more so than RDA. But yeah, very good game to Fusilier. And thanks for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And it's Unrivaled Skyrim signing off for now. Peace out.